So in this video, we are going to cover how to set up our own unit types and then some of the other options that are available on this control. Now, right now we are in settings, serialized items, and then unit types. That will open this control, and basically in the very simple, most simplistic statement I can make, this allows you to create your own unit types. You can create unit types for anything and everything that you sell in your business. There are no limitations. There's no limitations on how many you can have or what they say or anything else. So that pretty much covers the operational part of this left-hand column that we have here. To add a new one in, you basically just click here, type in the name you want to use, and hit the plus sign. These other options we're about to talk about. Now, in some states, you have the requirement to pay the clerk of courts, for example, whenever I sell an ATV, or maybe whenever I sell a motorcycle. If I sell a generator or a trailer, I don't have to pay those up front. I'll pay those whenever I pay the monthly sales tax figures. So this option, send taxes to purchase order, is basically there for me to be able to tell the system that whenever I close out a deal that has an ATV on it, I need you to generate a purchase order to the clerk of courts so that I can make sure that I get that amount paid. The next field that we have here is the major unit tax vendor. Now, in settings, whenever you set up your tax for your state or your county or whatever it happens to be, there is a field over there that you set to be the major unit tax vendor. And you're basically telling Lizzy that whenever you send this to a purchase order, I want you to send it to this tax vendor. But by default, Lizzy is going to look in the tax settings first, which means that if I've set the tax settings and everything gets sent to the same clerk of courts, then I do not need to go in and set any of these fields. And that's, you know, just as an example, it's why they're all blank here, because in this particular dealership, these taxes are actually sent to the same clerk of courts. So there's no reason to go in and set all of these. And I'll show you how to set it in just a moment. The next column that we have here is the tax type. Now, as you can imagine, because we allow you to type anything you want to over here in the left-hand column, we have to know specifically what things are so that we can make sure we calculate the taxes correctly. So this tax type field is basically there for you to choose the type that most closely resembles the thing that you created on the left. So as an example down here, you'll notice these last three things have got Z Sport, Z Street Bike, and Z Street Sport. But they're all tagged as a tax type for street bike, which means, and there's also a street bike up here, which means that when Lizzy sees a type motorcycle, and it comes time to calculate the taxes, she sees that it's supposed to create a purchase order, and then she looks over here to see what type of unit this is so that we can make sure we generate the taxes properly. So this tax type field is very, very important if you have to tax certain types of units differently than others. So you want to make sure that you get it set. If it doesn't matter, if there is no special tax situation going on, then you don't have to set this field either. Now the pencil over here is there to edit. So as an example, I can hit the pencil here. And this is where I was talking about that you could set the major unit tax vendor. We're basically overriding the default whenever you set this. If the default that's in the tax settings, and I'll show you where that is in just a moment, but if the setting over there is okay, then you don't really need to set this. You will also get a trash can over here if you've never used this unit type before. So if I created a new unit type and saved it, it's never been used on a unit before, I can delete those. So if you don't see a trash can, it's because there is a unit in your inventory that is already using that type, and therefore you can't get rid of it. So that is really all there is to setting up the different unit types. Now, I want to show you one thing. If we go over here to our actual tax rates, and of course, my internet would have to hiccup at that moment. So right here, you can see major unit tax vendor. So whenever I set up my different rates, I have the ability up here to tell it who the major unit tax vendor is. So if I set it here, I do not have to set it on the individual unit types unless it is different than what I put over here in this particular section.